Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how you can add your own materials in SketchUp. All right, so this is a project that I'm working on, and I've added my own stone texture down here. Go to my default tray. If you need that, go to Window, Default Tray. This will say Show Tray instead of Hide Tray. You want to use the material dropdown, and then in model, it'll show you all the textures that you're currently using. So if I use the eyedropper tool and select on that material, you can see then I have it. There's also this little tab that says edit, and I can change the color of it. It's pretty subtle. This is the hue. There's also the S is saturation. So if you want it to be grayscale, you would bring that all the way down to zero. And this is just like super blown out, super vibrant, or saturated is probably a better term. I think vibrance is actually a little bit different. And then B is brightness. So I like to use these three. There's also the color wheel, HLS and RGB if you prefer those. This little thing up here is undo, so it just resets everything that I just did. Colorize is sort of like a monochromatic application of the color over what you're doing. So that's also useful. And then if you just want, sometimes I like to just have sort of like the matte look. Maybe I'll start with an image and then I don't want it anymore. So you can just select that little thing, that little check mark, and it'll get rid of it. And then you have to re-upload it like I just experienced there. And I'm going to show you how to do that. This is the scale. So if you want to make that larger or smaller, you would use that. This lock thing right here unlocks. This is unlocked ratio. So I could change these independently. So I could change this to a 3'6", and the vertical won't change. But if it is locked and I change this to 5', you can see that the other one doesn't change either. It should. It's not. I'm not sure why. This looks like it's supposed to do something, but it's just for fun. And then opacity is how transparent that is. What we're going to do here is we're going to actually make a new material. And what happens when you select your create material is it's going to duplicate what material you're currently on. So you can see here material 3. And let's say I want to use that texture image. So I'm going to go to downloads and find, this is called get image. So I just load that in. And then if you want to tweak the color a little bit, let's say I wanted this to be gray. Or at least a somewhat gray. Still want that earthy tone to it, but I just want it to be more gray. So I'm going to select that, and then I'm going to go in here, and then I'm going to have to paint because that's now a new material. Now, because this, the way that I did this is probably not the most efficient because everything is in a separate group. Actually, it's not. I'm going to hide these really quick. Because these are all the same material, I can come in here, right-click, and do select all with same material. Let's say I wanted to save that original material and then paint on there. And for some reason, maybe these, those are in a group, a separate group. That's why I couldn't do it. So you can just come in here and paint those separately. Now if I think this, and this is the same issue, is that this is a group, so I couldn't select it. Now if I think the scale of this is off, I can always come in and change that. Let's say I make that 3 feet, then that feels a little bit more appropriate, and you can always mess with the hue and the saturation and the brightness and continue to do that throughout your modeling. So that's how you add a new material. Hopefully this video helped. If you liked it, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.